Jack.
So you know my title, how we met. We met on Tinder, actually. In like 2019?
Yeah. I think so, 2019.
Sheesh.
Give like your side of the story. Like what the fuck was you doing on Tinder?
Alright, so this was my first year in college. And I had just got out of a, not just, like that year I got out of a relationship.
Right.
Your ass be lying.
Okay, whatever.
And my friend from college, Shelly, she was on Tinder, and I was like, girl, you found an apps? And she's like, yes, like, they work. So I matched to him, and then we actually didn't link up for, like, a month or two.
Don't look at me. Tell your side of the story, and I'll tell the world my side of the story.
Okay, so this is what happened. One day, we were on FaceTime at night. It was, like, in December, around Christmas time. We were on FaceTime. He's asking me mad questions, like, he seems so cute and interested. And I was like, oh my god, like, I was like, it's not just gonna be a link. So, what? I went on Instagram, like, a few days later, and he posted up with some girl. Publicly.
Well, let's be nice. Yeah. Let's be nice. We don't have to go there. I mean, you're not wrong, but you didn't have to say it. I mean, good lord.
He didn't have sneaky links. He had links, and he did not care. Yeah. Clearly, because he would post them, and I'm just like, oh, so I see what this is. So from there on, I treated him as such.
And
anytime we link after that, it was literally just us linking. Like, there was no communication. It was
what
just,
do you mean by just us linking, bro? Anyways, let me tell y'all my side of the story, bro. I went on Tinder to, you know, further my Bible study program.
Stop the cap!
Right? Nah, I went on Tinder being a whore, summer 2019.
No, it was the winter time.
Winter time, so, you know, it was getting cold outside. Around my birthday, you feel me? I seen Shorty on Tinder. I was like, all right, somebody gotta cross off the hit list, you feel me?
Oh, what? Whoa! Wait, one second!
Anyway, so we met. We'll talk like here and there. We wouldn't really like talk a lot, but like, we'll probably slide open each other's shit on social media and have like a brief 2 second conversation. And then that was it. When did we meet up? Like a couple months after?
December. The end of December. Or January.
I know it was like a while before we linked. So it was like, let's say 2 months after, we finally linked up.
He's nasty.
I'm nasty.
Easy.
Anyway, so we linked up. This is what happened. We linked up. I used my man's whip, right? Because my car was acting up. I did not know his car was acting up too. So he gave me his car. I go over there. She was like 30 minutes away from me. I go over there. All right. Shorty hops in the car. I'm like, I remember he said some weird shit.
It's like, you're calling me weird.
And I was like,
I was just showing
him
my
weird
true colors.
No. So we both knew what it was when we was linking, right? So it's not like I'm taking her to Applebee's or anywhere. Like, I get there, niggas do what they gotta do and dip, you feel me? Don't act like that. You knew exactly what type of timing it was.
I feel like he hit on the first night.
Right, nigga, I hit on the first night. So, getting a whip, driving off. So I'm like, all right, it's your town. Like, point me to the spots. Like, point me to the spots. We're about to do this shit. I don't even go outside.
I just moved out here.
I don't care, bro. It's just like, I don't even know. Blah, blah. Now I'm tight. Now I'm like, bro, I came here to kill him. And now this extra shit, bro. So, we found some like random spot by her crib and shit. And then we was talking for a little bit. And the car died. Keep in mind, it's in December. It's cold. First link, car died. Now I look like a broke ass nigga. You feel me? Now I'm just like, fuck, right? I ain't showing the outside, but in the inside, I'm like, bro, I just cussed myself some pussy. I just cussed myself.
That was before.
No.
That was after me.
It was before. I know exactly what I'm talking about. If any nigga in that situation, bro, they'll know exactly. They'll remember everything. So car died. It's not even my car, right? So now I'm embarrassed. Secondhand embarrassed. And Shorty's sitting in the passenger seat looking mad pretty, confused, all of that shit. I'm like, fuck, what's going on through her head? You feel me? And then, so I called my mans. Shout out to Ryan's. Called this nigga. He's 30 minutes away. And I'm like, bro, you gotta come save me. I didn't even clap yet, and the car died, right?
He was singing Creole too, so I didn't know what he was talking about, and I got scared. I was like, oh, like, who are you talking to? What are you talking about?
So my man is like, I bet I'll be there quick. And knowing him, when he tells you he's gonna be there quick, bro, he's gonna be there quick. So I have 30 minutes to try to make some shit happen. Cause in my head, I'm like, yeah, she never linking me again. You feel me? I'm thinking like, she's gonna be like, oh, you broke ass nigga, your car can't even stay on. It's cold outside, you got me freezing and shit. So I'm like, fuck, they got a 30 minute window, right? So, I don't know. We just kept talking about some other shit. And you know, typical nigga shit, nigga try to slide away. So the backseat is looking kind of empty back there, you feel me? Kind of lonely. So she's like, we on it. I'm like, oh.
Stop talking about business.
Bro, so I was like, bet. So we hopped in the back. And niggas did what they was doing, you feel me? They was doing some grown people shit. And then in the midst of grown people shit, I see my man's headlights popping out, bro. Keep in mind, my butt was like facing the window and the headlights was shining on my cheeks, bro. So I'm like, yo. And the windows are not tinted. So like, I don't know. This man never spoke about it. I don't know what he saw, what he didn't see. So, comes out, we got dressed, right? He stayed in his car till we got out the car. And then we had her sitting in a nice, heated, started car. And it was figuring out what's wrong with my man's car. Then, shit worked out. Yada, yada, yada. So, I dropped her off. We got lost. Like, we're literally 2 minutes from her house. She could not direct me back to her house. But I was getting irritated at that point.
I had just moved out there. Like, I told you this.
I wasn't listening. That was exactly how we met, like our first encounter. We didn't start dating till like a year or two later.
2020. So that summer, that was in like December, right? So then we kept like linking again after that, but not frequently, like.
Maybe like once every fucking 2 months or a month or whatever.
Yeah. Until the summertime. The summertime we actually, for a few weeks. So summertime came and he was still outside posting his
links. What do you mean I was still outside? What were you? Outside.
We were both outside.
We outside.
We were both being sluts.
Publicly putting we were both my being sluts.
Thoughts. Yours is privately. I just didn't care.
He would put shorties out there, like not their business, but like that he's linking with them, basically, like videos and shit, and I'm like, that's not the same girl that was in the video yesterday.
It don't matter. I was single. I was doing single people shit.
Right.
We were sluts outside. Like, it's all good. Go ahead.
Yeah. Anyways, I did cheerleading at my old college. So one time I was coming back and he was picking me up from the train station. And that's when we made the videos.
Say that again.
I kind of look like I wasn't just getting big.
That's not acting normal, nigga.
We were in the bathroom and like there were cute little videos of both of us and he posted them. And I remember sending it to my friends and I was like, y'all, you know, he posted me. Like, put me out into the world. We didn't follow any of the same people, so I didn't care. I would only hit him up for that. Like, that was it. No, I don't wanna hang out. Not that I didn't want to, but.
Bro, let me tell you something. So, I'm not even trying to like, I don't want to sound like, you know, cocky or unhumble or whatever, right? I be showing out. You feel me? It's like I'm used to, like, linking a girl, have sex, they get attached or whatever, right? So I expected the same shit. But this girl is not giving me the attention or whatever. Like, you feel me? She'll only hit me up for literally the eggplant emoji and I'm supposed to know what that means. Like, not even how's your day, how's your morning, none of that shit. So, like, being the little whore that I was, I'll still go, you feel me? I'll still go over there and get mines, but like feel like a little slut after. I remember I used to go back, tell my mans about it, tell my sister, tell my friends, like who the she thinks she is, like she's using me as a piece of meat, you feel me? All of that, but I'll still go back. Like I'll sore up and I'm like, I'm done talking to shorty, like it's not right. yada, yada, yada. Like, I'm starting to feel how females feel now. Like, you know, this is not right. Like, I'm starting a whole movement. Like, this is not okay. We can't be doing this to people. That shit kept bothering me. So, like, one day I was like, nah, I'm confronting her. So I hit her up, like, with a long-ass paragraph, like, expressing.
That was
because
you said you missed me.
Oh, yeah, hold up. I hit her up, yeah, talking about, like, I miss you. Wait, what'd you say? Yeah, talking about, bro. Like, I never felt so embarrassed. I felt embarrassed for me. Like, I'm embarrassed and I felt embarrassed for me. Like, that shit was like, I stooped so, you know when you put your pride aside? You feel me? And it's like, wow. Anyways.
Hey, cutie, you didn't respond.
Yeah, so she goes the next day, try to hit me up on some hey, cutie.
Audacity to leave me on red.
Yes. I was learning to respect myself. I was learning to have self-respect because this was too much. Too much. Anyways, so fast forward. I wrote like a long-ass paragraph talking about you're not going to use me like that. You're not going to treat me like that. Like I'm not a person. Talking about eggplant emoji and then go home after. Not even like, oh, how was your day? Like, did you make it home safely? None of that shit, bro.
Oh, my God.
None of that shit. But like, so we spoke about it or whatever. The thing is, I was at a point in my life, like, I was not trying to, like, catch feelings for anybody. So, like, the feelings that I did have, I was suppressing them. You feel me? Like, I was just trying to keep it as, like, oh, I don't got feelings for this girl. I just want to, whatever. But at the same time, I want the emotional invest into it because that's what I'm used to from other people. And I wasn't getting it. But anyway, so we talked about it. And then I linked her up like the next night, and we was again at the train station.
It was lit.
Yeah, and she was like tipsy or whatever. And then she was like trying to give me like ultimatums and shit.
No.
It's either your attention is to me,
right? If you want to talk to me, then
it's gonna stay as if you're just trying to whatever.
That's that. You can't talk to me. You can't expect me to give you. You know, sex plus my attention.
It's
one or the other.
That's funny. Shit is ridiculous. Shit is ridiculous. But anyways, so here we are, about to be like a year. Strong into this. I don't know what else to say. This is our first actual YouTube video.
It is.
It's gonna get better.
Everyone's been asking us like how we met.
Yeah, that's why we did this, because a lot of people really ask like, how did y'all meet or whatever.
If any of my friends see this and they'd be like, I thought you met on Instagram. Because I've been lying to people saying we met on Instagram.
I'd be lying. I'm like, we was both being dots. We was both being sluts, and that's how we came about. So there's hope for y'all out there.
Don't sleep on Tinder.
Don't sleep on Tinder, and don't listen to people that tells you, oh, you can't make a relationship because y'all fucked the first night.
He was an easy kill.
Right. I had self-respect.
Right.
She was talking about, oh, let's hop in the back, big boy. It's like, excuse me, ma'am? But anyways, moral of the story is, fuck who you want to fuck on the first night. It does not limit you from having a relationship with them.
And ladies, don't think that you got to sit here and entertain these niggas just because y'all fucking.
Man, have some self-respect. If she's not giving you attention, none of that, don't give her dick. Please.
You really think niggas is gonna die?
Yes.
You were still coming back. What are you talking about?
I was not. I was learning to love myself, okay?
Wait, what would you say to Ryan?
It's
like, she used me?
Yeah, you was using me. And that was the process I was taking, like, you know, starting to love myself. But anyways,
He couldn't handle his own medicine.
Follow our TikTok. It's JAVIII. That's 3 I's. 0926. TikTok banned us, like, 2-3 times.
My God.
We had videos hitting million views, and they shadow felt like banned us. They shadow banned. They took down our page. Anyways, so that's JAVIII 3I0926. Follow our Instagram. It's JAVII_0926. We're gonna try to be consistent with the videos. Our next video actually is gonna be interesting.
Comment down below some more videos for us to do. Story times. If you guys want pranks.
Story times. All of that. Comment. Whatever. We're open to suggestions. And I don't know why you're looking at me like that.
Because pranks, baby.
But, yes. Our next video. It's story time. Our first.
Oi! We're gonna.
How we had our first threesome. Bye!
I would have had these bitches, we back in these bitches, then throwing them all in the jam. We gon' get litty in cities and run up the bitties and let y'all niggas do the math. We want the rags and bitches, the baddest bitches, my niggas be litty right now.